Hello, world. Today, I wanted to share with you the journey of a Japanese retail worker that quit a job to grow premium grapes in one of Japan's grape capitals, Okayama. In recent years, premium or incredibly expensive Japanese grapes have been somewhat trendy online. And it's kind of understandable, especially if you live in a country where fruit is typically affordable and not considered a luxury item. So in this video, we'll show you the process of growing such pricey grapes, go over the history of grape farming in Japan, and even taste test some distinct grape varieties. Conveniently, Bobby, who helps on some of the edits, lives in Okayama and was able to film several times throughout the year to capture the grape growing from start to finish. You might recognize him from the Being Japanese documentary, the What Driving in Japan is Like video, or What a Japanese Bicycle Shop is Like video. Anyway, without further ado, let's go visit Bobby's farmer friend, Sakamoto-san.
ボビーが話しかけたら俺は話せばいいってこと？いいよ、ボビーに対して。
ああ、で、勝手に言いたいことがあったら全然いいし。
ああじゃあもう、
いいよいいよ。
はい。
So, this is our first visit in April when the vines have grown long enough for Sakamoto-san to start organizing them into rows. Once the vines reach a certain size, Sakamoto-san uses a tape gun to pin down the vines. This is done for two main reasons: to ensure that sunlight hits as many leaves as possible, and to even out the spread of nutrients throughout the vines.
こういうふうにここら辺見とってよ。ポキって鳴らして、倒して。で、ポキって折れるしな、無理くりにしたら。ほら、こうやって折れる。無理にしたらな。したらまあこれがもうブドウにならんから、ここの部分が。もう1000円落とす感じ。分からんけど。
In simple terms, from March to May, he focuses on letting the vines and leaves grow, so they can form big leaves and capture the energy of the sun. But from May onwards, the focus is to send nutrients to the berries. So at the end of the vines, he nips some leaves and buds to signal to the tree to start diverting its resources.
これもうほんま硬いとなる。
Here it may look like he's pruning away tiny grapes, but these are actually flowers. Once they've self-pollinated, the lucky ones become grape berries. The reason Sakamoto-san is trimming away at them is to avoid overcrowding and to try and shape the grape bundles. The size and number of these flower buds depends on the variety of grape. So for example, the variety called Muscat of Alexandria typically has hundreds of buds per vine. And that's why this variety is so labor-intensive. Sakamoto-san has to trim down each and every one of these bundles, otherwise, the berries will overcrowd and burst. Other varieties, like the Shine Muscat, have relatively few flower buds, so they don't require as much manual labor during this step of the process.
あっちこんだけあったが、あれは10センチから13センチにして、あのままブドウのあの房にするんよ。これは 3.5 センチにして、ここから植物ホルモンの液剤につけて、で、種をなくして、よりこう大きくさせるように、人為的に持っていって、で、ハサミ入れる回数はもうチンチンチュンぐらい。
The Shine Muscat, which were invented in Japan in 2006, have quickly become some of the most prized grapes in the country. Despite other grape varieties losing demand over the past decade, Shine Muscat has only become more popular. So it makes sense then for more grape farmers to simply produce Shine Muscat over other varieties like Muscat of Alexandria, which not only sell for half of what Shine Muscat sells for,but also takes at least twice as much time to trim. And on top of that, Muscat of Alexandria grapes are quite susceptible to diseases, whereas Shine Muscat are quite hardy and resistant to germs.
Shine Muscat だったら単純に簡単に言ったらだけど3時間でできることが、このアレキサンドリアだったら8時間かかるとか、倍ぐらいある、倍以上あるな。
で、値段は、
値段は安いっていう。値段ももう半分以下かもしれん。安さで言ったら、その売り方にもよるんだけど。で、さらに、これ種ありぶどうなんよ。需要がないっていうのがあるかもしれんな。単純に。種あるのって、やっぱ子供とかも食べやすい食べにくいの判断にもなるし、 どっちかと子供とかってやっぱ甘いがごちそうだったりするが、これはまあどっちか上品な香りを楽しんでもらったり、甘さがないわけじゃないけど、美味しさの向こう側わからんけど甘いの向こう側。
So for a little backstory, Sakamoto-san has only been a farmer for a little over 3 years. Before he entered the world of grape farming, he worked retail.But during the COVID-19 pandemic, he re-evaluated his career path and decided to become his own boss, working with nature. And after doing some research, he found an opportunity to do a paid apprenticeship through a local grape farmer named Hayashi-san. Hayashi-san is an uke-ire noka, or a farmer who is subsidized by the government to help raise young farmers. Just like how the national population is in decline, so too is the number of farmers throughout Japan. But given how many greenhouses and mature grape trees there are throughout Okayama,It would be a huge waste of resources to let them rot away and no longer contribute to the local economy. And so, Sakamoto-san apprenticed at the Hayashi Vineyard for 2 years before setting off on his own.
最初はもうほんまに理科習いおる感じかな。最初の感じって植物育てるのにどういう何が必要かとかも全くわからんかったから。でも今の答えは水と太陽かな。
The greenhouse that Sakamoto-san rents are owned by veteran farmers, but he gets to profit from the trees that were already there. Some of them are up to 15 years old. And others, like this one, were planted by Sakamoto-san himself just over a year ago. This little guy won't be producing grapes on any notable scale for another 4 years. Raising grape trees is a relatively long-term investment without any guaranteed yield. So renting grape trees that are ready to produce berries to their fullestis appealing.
40本ぐらいかな、木が。で、ハウスが、15棟。それで、500坪ぐらいか。の量になる。
So in June, our second day of shooting, the berries had already grown to about the size of small blueberries. And here, Sakamoto-san calls the grapes, leaving behind only the best looking berries in optimal locations on the vine.
これ今多分ハサミ入れてない状態で粒同士がぶつかり合ってぶつかると皮がそんなに硬くないから破裂して腐ります。腐ってもうで腐れた汁が垂れていったらもう全部それがどんどんどんどん広がっていってもう食べれないっていうのを、これがだいたい100房ぐらいあるかな。目パッサパサなるけ、これも賞味早めの方がいいよ。A って言われる。この粒を落とせば、その粒にいっとった養分が他に行くからっていうので、玉太りが良くなるとかって言われる。よう口が開く、あと。ポカーってやってしまう。
The orange tags you see on the stem help identify which grapes have been treated with a growth hormone called gibberellin.Organically grown grapes that don't use growth hormone will have smaller berries.
で、つけたのとつけてないのと、初めは花が満開になる時期っていうのが全部が全部一緒じゃないから、こうつけたものに対してはクリップをつけていってっていうような感じで、まあ今は全部ついてるんですけど、目視できるようにこういうふうにしてます。そうやな、野生ブドウって言われるのは甘みもそんなに強くないし、うん、あんま大きくならんかな、やっぱホルモンつけんし。でも大きくさせるもどうなんだろうな、難しいとこやな、考え方としては。
Something I didn't know was that regardless of what type of grape variety a tree originally produces, farmers can graft branches of other varieties to that mother tree. This can result in one tree producing multiple varieties of grapes if the grafting is successful.So instead of spending 5 years to grow a grape variety, it could theoretically only take one.
2年生、まだ2年生は実がなりません。3年生になっても実が、4分の1程度、種ではない、苗木から買ってほんまこの状態で、でそっから刺しておいたら芽がぷくって、ね、で芽かぎっていう作業をしてあげるんよ。どの芽を使おうかなって選んであげて、芽を絞ったらそこから芽が出て、芽から葉が出て、でニョロニョロニョロニョロニョロって伸びていくような感じ。一応まあこういうつるの特性を生かしてというか、 ブドウを誘導してあげたら、まあ誘導してあげたらこういうふうに、これ自体が木化していく感じで、木化していったらこういうふうになって、で年を重ねるとこのコブみたいなメザっていうんだけど、このメザがごっつくなっていくような感じ。社員不発したら、まあまた1年だっけ、また来年からじゃっけ、1年これになったらもう5年かかるってことだから、5年後俺は42歳の年か、42かーってなる。
Sakamoto-san grows several varieties of grapes, including Shine Muscat, Muscat of Alexandria, Shien, Oriental Star, Seto Giant, and more. There are said to be over 100 grape varieties throughout Japan. One of Sakamoto-san's favorite grapes, the Seto Giant, has a unique shape that he describes here as a butt chin. And you know what? I can't argue with that.
シャインもちょっとケツアゴチックなやつが大きくなるな。
他の農家さんとかも、
いや、言わんと思うな。俺だけかもしれない。
On a side note, for fertilizer, he uses bat dung, crushed crab shells, fermented bamboo chips, powdered seaweed, rice straw, and grass.
発酵させたら乳酸菌が増えて堆肥化して土にいい影響を与えてくれるっていう風に、まあそれをまいていい菌を増やすっていう狙いがあるけど、増えたかどうかは分からん。
Grapes might have first arrived in Japan during the Nara period in the 7th century from China and Korea. But significant cultivation practices didn't start for another 1,000 years or so until the Meiji period, which, as some of you might know, was a time of rapid modernization and Western influence. The Japanese government wanted Japanese wine to succeed, so they supported not only wineries, but grape farmers as well. So the first Western-style vineyard was started in 1877 in Yamanashi Prefecture, which is to this day one of the largest producers of grapes in Japan.Farmers faced quite a few challenges though. First, most North American and European grape varieties did not suit the Japanese climate very well. And second, a pest called Phylloxera had wiped out millions of hectares of vineyards throughout Europe and America and had traveled to Japan as well. The pests had gotten so bad that the government gave up on their national wine development project. But luckily, a researcher named Kanzawa Tsuneo determined which American grape varieties had grown resistance to Phylloxera and would be well suited to Japanese climates.These varieties were Concord, Kofu, and Delaware. He also helped teach grape grafting techniques to Japanese farmers and essentially saved the Japanese table grape industry. And since the 1950s, the Japanese have continued to innovate and produce hundreds of new grape varieties, some of which sell for ridiculously high prices. It's now July, and it's the third time we're visiting the vineyard.
Ah, ほらほら、これ、ボビー。色がつき始めてる。
By this point, most of the grapes look ready to eat. They're plump and vibrant. But Bobby told me he tried one and it was not nearly as appetizing as it looked. The sugar content of the grapes at this point are still far too low to be sold at market. They're basically just tantalizing pouches of water. But that said, filling these grapes up with water is a crucial step. The roots of the trees absorb water from the soil and send it to the grape berries.But if the farmer waters the trees too much, too quickly, the berries will burst. So it's a delicate balancing act, where the tree needs to be kept just hydrated enough to stay thirsty, but not dry out too much either. This gradual and consistent watering process helps the berries expand without bursting.
水が今一番こう軟化期って言って、触ってもらったら柔らかいんよ、ブドウが。もう今まではカチカチだったんだけど、パリンと割れたらもうそこから腐っていく。その割れたのを取り除かんと、もうあとはそのブドウの汁が腐れになってもう全部腐って終わりになるから、だからそこが一番今難しいかな。これ昨日あげたんだけど、昨日でもこっちの火当たっとるとことかはもうちょっと乾き気味にもなってきてるし、200リッターは使っとるかな。
Watering the soil on the surface level also helps cool down the greenhouses during some of the hottest days of the year. And Sakamoto-san showed us that during this watering period, some berries can go into shock from sudden changes in their environment and can shrivel up or darken. So while there is a science behind it all, knowing how to attend to the various weather, soil, and tree conditions requires an experienced touch.
うん。あ、これもあるな。うん。
それは
食べれる？別に。でも見た目の問題。うん。これぐらいだったら食べれる。そこだけ硬かったりするんよ。
Around this time, Sakamoto-san covers the shine muskets with green paper to not only protect them from bugs and mold, but to also help maintain their distinctive green color. If left exposed to the sun, the rays would darken the skin. And it's possible that direct sunlight might make the skin a bit harder too. And since shine muskets are known to be very sweet and easy to eat due to their lack of seeds and thin skin, this is a crucial part of raising them. On the other hand,Purple varieties like Oriental Star need to be evenly exposed to sunlight to prevent splotchy coloring. The more even the color, the more it sells for.
で、こういうオリエンタル、まあ、この品種はこれなんで色がつくかって言ったら光で色がつく。植物性ホルモンの反応で。ってなったらこれに例えば緑色の袋つけたらおそらくもう色付きがまばらになっちゃう。そうなるとちょっと組合出荷とかになったら金額が下がったりとか、その色がまばらなだけで。
Sakamoto-san also removes any new sprouts or buds growing on the vines. Since it's well past the leaf growing period, these sprouts will only take away nutrients from the grapes. So it's an important process to help sweeten the grapes before harvest. And regarding sweetness, grapes and many other fruit in Japan are measured by degree in Brix measurements. And a high market value shine muscat will have a Brix measurement of 16 to 18 degrees.At this point in the process, a week of sunny weather will probably increase the sugar content of these grapes by 1 degree, meaning that cloudy or rainy weather can delay the market sale of these grapes by weeks sometimes. But something to note is that in Japan, there is a special gift-giving season called Ochigen, which typically runs from mid-July to mid-August. It's basically a mid-year custom to show appreciation to family or friends that you owe a lot to. And a very common gift is luxury fruit.And like any item that is in high demand during a holiday season, this causes huge spikes in prices. So there's a big incentive for some grape farmers to produce ready-to-eat shine muscats by mid-July. If left to mostly natural means, the optimal shine muscat harvest season is between September and October. So in order to harvest them up to 2 months earlier, farmers have to artificially heat up their greenhouses using gasoline-powered boilers.This process is expensive, but if they manage to sell their grapes during Ochigen season, they can potentially double their profits or even more. Another grape cultivation process that I hadn't seen before was manually realigning the grapes on the vine. By doing so, it ensures that some grapes don't get squished, but also, it helps improve the symmetry of the bundle, raising its market price. Now we're on to our fourth visit. As we mentioned before, Sakamoto-san tries to reduce the use of pesticides.But some pests will infect the grapes as early as June or July and won't show any signs until near harvest season in August or September.
これバンプ病って言って腐る病気。
So the timing is key when it comes to using pesticides. Sakamoto-san doesn't necessarily dislike pesticides, but understands why consumers could be put off by them.
5、6月って結構農薬かけるんよ。本当、本当というかその防除及び通りに行けば。だけど農薬減らしとるから。まあ、そのリスクがここに来て出るっていうこと。
At this point in the season, Sakamoto-san focuses on harvesting and packaging the grapes. This season, Sakamoto-san's harvest was not as bountiful as he'd hoped. A large part of his crop got eaten by pests. So while he didn't go in the red, he was far from his goal of making 100,000 in revenue. It sounds like a lot, but considering he pays $500 a month renting the greenhouses, paying part-time workers, and supporting a family, it's not all that much. But despite the challenges, he enjoys the work and is quite optimistic about the future. So we wish Sakamoto-san all the best, and if you want to check out his website or social media accounts, I've left them in the description. Anyway, once the harvesting is completed in November, Sakamoto-san will cut down most of the vines and add them to the compost heap.During the winter, he and the trees take some much-deserved time off. I'd never really thought about it before, but after producing so much fruit, trees get tired too. So the off-season is important to let the trees recuperate. Some farms do double harvesting, in which a grape tree will produce grapes twice a year. But this can be taxing on the trees, cost more natural resources, like gas and water, and might not produce grapes that are as high quality.Bobby did some very unscientific taste testing.You might notice the shiny air bubbles surrounding the grapes in the water. This is called bloom, and it's caused by the pollen on the surface of the grapes. It's a sign of freshness.
じゃあこれがアレキサンドリア、マスカットオブアレキサンドリア。
お。
これはまあ皮は一応食べれないっていうふうには歌っとるけど、
うん、
種がある昔から岡山で、ここの岡山ではすごい作られてる品種。
アレキサンドリア。うん、okay.
香りが一番強いブドウ。
甘いというよりも、なんか本当に、うん、
上品な甘みというか、
うん、なんかシャンパンは多分合ってないけど、
うん、
でもやっぱり何か香水とか、
そうそうそうそうそう、ムスク香とかっていうな、
うん、
マスカット香、
美味しいなこれ、
うん、で今度これ瀬戸ジャイアンツ、俺一番惜しい、これは
これなんか
お尻みたいな形が特徴。
そうだね、うん、英語だったらなんかブリ
ー、あ
ーバボバっていうのは、うん、バブルバットっていうか、
へ
え、ね、これ入ってる？
種ない、はい、もう全部食える、皮ごと。
そうだね、食感がやっぱりアピールだねこれ、
うん、ないじゃろう皮が、
ないし
美味しいじゃろ
う、これ楽しいね食べるの、
美味しいだろう、
なんかポンポンってなんか
全然違うだろう、
もうすぐ食べれるっていうか、
これ同じやけん、
子供もなんか好きそう。
ああそうやな、食べやすいしな。
なんか
一応あの皮ごと食べれるブドウですの走りがこの瀬戸ジャイアンツ。
面白いのが海外だとさ、ほとんどみんな皮食べるから。でもこれいいね。
いいだろう。
いや。
これが冬ブドウシエン。ポロッとでも身から外れるから、うん、口の中で多分取れる。すぐかじったら。
これめちゃくちゃね、
うん、
アメリカとかチレ、チリ、
うんうん、
とかで食べるブドウみたい。
あ、そうなんだ。こんな感じなんだ。
アメリカで買う、なんかスーパーで買う、
うん、
ブド
ウ、うん、すごい似てる、
うん、
だから懐かしい。
あれ良かったね。
これがな、オリエンタルスター
。オリエンタルスター
。果肉、これ食感が面白い。オ
ッケ
ー、うん、食べてみて。種ない。
なんか多分くどくない。
うん、そうじゃな。
甘すぎるとさ、
うん、喉が焼けるような甘さもあるもんな。
もうデザートみたいになっちゃうから、うん、でもさっきのはなんか本当におやつで。
そうそうそうそう、ポリポリ食べれるような。
いいね。
これがシャイン。
シャイン。うん、これが有名な。
大体まあブドウ界のサラブレッドって言われるよな。
じゃあシャインマスカット。ボワーって
甘みは強いな。
なんか、綿飴、
うん、
みたい。
あ、
じゃ
あ
ポンキャンディーみたいな。もう本当にもう溶けてなんかピューっていう、うん、
こう強い甘さがグンってくるのがシャインかな。瀬戸ジャイアンツとかってちょっと上品、2回目に食べたお尻みたいなブドウ、あれって甘さあるけど上品な甘さ、長く食べれるような甘さというか。
そうそうそう。
なぜこんなリスクが高いさ、仕事したいの？
偏ったら逆に言えば休めるよな、冬は。冬はその稼ぐ時、稼ぐが好き、好きというか面白いかなと思って。だからブドウがぶら下がった以上はもう こいつらに合わせて動くけど、こいつらがもう収穫してなくなったらもう自分都合で動けばいいから。何曜日に土作りをしよう、土作るために竹をチップにしよう、茅をチップにしようとかっていうのはもう自由じゃから。
なんか坂本さんみたいになんか若いさ、うん、ブドウ農家さんとかって多いと思う？
うん、少ない方だと思う。農家の平均年齢70代80代。じゃあもう10年後って荒れ地になるか、ちゃんと引き継げばその人たちが相続なんかいろいろもろもろ引き継げばいい形にはなるけど、うん、そうじゃないっていうパターンの方が多い気がする。
なんか日本の果物ってさ、やっぱりアメリカに最近行った時、うん、日本の果物だけなって思って。やっぱ
あー、だけよな。
でもアメリカはおかしいほど安い、うん、
あ、
なんかやっぱり海外から輸入してるから。
あ、高いけど売り値が高いけど、うん、仕入れは安すぎるから農家が一番打撃を食らうというか。年にやっぱ1回しかできんからっていうのがあるかもな。何回も取れるようなものじゃないから。で日本って多分四季がある。春夏秋冬の多分流れじゃないかな。春にはこれ食べよう、夏にはこれ食べよう、秋にこれ食べよう、冬にはこれ食べようみたいな。 ある意味洗脳じゃねえけど印象がついてるよなやっぱ。
かもね。
うん。ボビーこれあげるわじゃあ。
For all his hard work, Bobby was gifted with a bundle of Seto Giant and Oriental Star. But for everyone else, Sakamoto-san sells his grapes, mostly through local markets, shops, and direct customers, or what he calls kouri. He doesn't sell overseas, but as you can imagine, luxury fruits like Shine Muscat are a valuable Japanese export, with a large market in Taiwan, Hong Kong, and other nearby countries. However, there's currently a grape rivalry happening between Japan, Korea, and China when it comes to Shine Muscat.You see, even though the Japanese National Agriculture and Food Research Organization, a bit of a mouthful, registered Shine Muscat in 2006, they only registered it in Japan. But according to the International Convention for the Protection of New Varieties of Plants, grapes must be registered within 6 years of having been registered in their home country. By the time the 2012 deadline had hit, smugglers had already started growing Shine Muscat in Korea and China. And because the Japanese government never registered for an international patent,They could not earn royalties on any Shine Muscat sold outside of Japan. According to Japan's Ministry of Agriculture, Forestry and Fisheries, Japan might have lost 10 billion yen a year in the past decade. Why didn't they apply for the international patent, you might ask? Well, they might not have intended on selling Shine Muscat overseas, or they simply didn't anticipate it to be as popular as it is. The government researches and develops new varieties of plants every year, and not every variety becomes a household name.So to patent every single one would not only be costly, but time-consuming. Anyways, it was fascinating to see the effort Sakamoto-san put into his grapes, and I wish that I was the one doing the taste testing in place of Bobby. But I do plan on ordering some myself this season, so I'll get the chance. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Peace. What are grapes like where you're from?